A big namaste to everyone. I welcome you all to the fifth episode of Hevel's School of Grooming. My name is Vishal Manucha and I represent a category called Hevel's Personal Care. You know, today I'm going to bring somebody on the screen who doesn't require much of the introduction. His name is Sankey Everoos. I hope all of you are doing well, and let me just add him. Sankey Everoos. Today's session is going to be really interesting as we talk about again a lot of styling tips. Yes, so I can see that, you know, Sankey is live with me. Sankey, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can. Can you hear me?
Okay, Sankey, can you hear me?
I can. Can you hear me?
Yes, great. Thank you, Sankey, for joining us. So I welcome you to the fifth episode of Hevel's School of Grooming, and I'm really, really obliged to have you today on this session. So we are going to talk about today one of the sessions, you know, which was kind of quite talked about, you know, myths about styling tools. Sankey, before I go on and, you know, talk more about Hevel's School of Grooming as a property, and then we talk about various styling hacks, I just wanted to tell you about what exactly is Hevel's School of Grooming. So this is a property, you know, which we started good 2.5 years back, and, you know, we come here, go live, and, you know, we talk about various style hacks, you know, various styling hacks, which people want to know that, you know, how can they look good? How can they flaunt? You know, how can they kind of, you know, go out and say that, you know, I now want to let it out with confidence. You know, School of Grooming has been a subsidiary of our positioning, which is none other than, you know, let it out. And good to have you today. I think, Sankey, you know, from here, maybe, you know, and just introduce yourself also quickly, maybe one or two lines about you. How have been your journey, you know, when you started your career?
Thank you so much, first of all, for making me a part of this Insta Live for Hevel's India. I'm really grateful right now. And when I talk about my journey, everybody has this question, how, you know, I made it to, you know, this level. Like, I'm not a trained hairstylist, and for me, you know, whatever I've achieved a little bit until now is all because of my mother, because of God, and it's nothing. So I never thought of becoming a hairstylist, to be honest. It's just that once one of my friends recommended me that, you know, there's this shoot and you just go and see if you can work. And I'm like, okay, fine. I can do hairstyling, but I have never, you know, done it professionally. And I used to, you know, style my sister's hair, my friend's hair. She said, you're doing so good. You need to go and, you know, build that confidence when it comes to hairstyling. She literally pushed me to go on that shoot. I went on that shoot. I did my job. I came back and they loved my work. And that's how the, you know, story started of my hairstyling journey started from that point onwards. And I did a couple of test shoots after that. So, you know, photographers started liking my work, and that's how I, you know, kept on doing shoots and shoots and shoots. And, you know, once you start working, there's no stopping to it. So even I enjoyed my work after that. And I'm like, if I'm doing good, if people are liking my work, then why not? Let's just do it. That's how it began at that point. And today I'm like, here. Yeah.
So,
I still am learning. I still want to learn. I don't want to call myself a successful person, because learning never stops, to be honest. There are a lot of things which I literally don't know, I feel, but I'm still trying and learning more and more about it.
So Sankey, I think I can just say one thing, you know, the kind of exceptional work we have been seeing, you know, styling various celebrities, and, you know, the way it is going, I don't think so that, you know, you can say that, you know, I'm still, of course, you know, everybody learns at, I mean, it's a journey. Everybody continues to learn. But then I think that, you know, the kind of a work you have been putting is really making us proud. At least, you know, a lot of people are still looking up to you, and, you know, they have a lot of hopes. You know, the kind of a trends, the kind of a styles you have been putting on celebs, I can tell you that, you know, this is such an amazing work. So, you know, as people also, you know, want to know that, you know, why do you call yourself as a self-taught hairstylist?
I call myself a self-taught hairstylist because there were a lot of people who have guided me through my entire career, but I had made a lot of mistakes when I started my hairstyling journey. And when I'm talking about my mistakes, a person learns from his mistakes. So I have learned from my own mistakes, which is why I'm calling myself a self-taught hairstylist. I'm thanking everyone who has guided me throughout the career until now. And I will be thanking a lot of people who will be guiding me in the future. But at the end of the day, you are the one who are doing and performing in the industry, and you are the one who is learning from your own mistakes. So that is something which I would like to, you know, credit myself for.
Without much ado, let's start, on the today's session. You know, as everyone is waiting that, you know, and they want to hear from you the styling hacks for the day. So let me tell you that, you know, the first thing which I think probably everybody wants to know is that, you know, there are certain styling tools available, you know, be it from the brand Hevels or be it from some other brand. But then, you know, people have certain myths and they feel that, you know, that these are the products which can cause a damage to their hair. And, you know, these are the products, maybe, you know, we can talk about creams, colors, curling tongs, straighteners. So various products are available in the market. But I mean, is that a myth, or you think that it just, you know, it's not something which kind of, you know, damages your hair? So what is your opinion on this?
Okay. So when it comes to hairstyling, I guess heat setting is the most important role in this entire styling thing. You know, heat is used from waving and curling to straightening and blow drying. So we use heat everywhere. When it comes to heat, you need to know the amount of heat you're using for your hair. And I wouldn't say using heat might damage your hair, but using correct amount of heat won't harm your hair is what my personal opinion is. So if you're selecting some tools which includes heat, you need to know the amount, you need to know how to use that particular tool, and you need to know the amount of heat required according to your hair and according to the hair quality. That's what I usually.
Absolutely correct. Yeah, right. Sankey, now, I mean, there is another thing, you know, which keeps coming to my mind is that, you know, there are various tools, you know, which people want to use. Let's say, you know, a hair dryer, a hair straightener, a curling tong. But then are these the tools, you know, which can be used by, I would say, you know, can these be called unisex tools, that a male uses a female grooming tools and a female grooming tools are being used by males? So is that something, you know, which is also possible these days?
Yeah, that's something which is the biggest myth of this industry, hairstyling industry. A lot of men think that, okay, straighteners or blow dryers or curlers are only being used by females. It's only used by females. We can't use it. But that's not the thing. Hair straightener from tongs, from blow dryers can also be used by men. I know it. If we talk about the tools of hairstyling, it has basic needs. What is the need of blow dryer? It dries your hair, right? What is the use of curling tong? It curls your hair. What is the use of straightener? It straightens your hair. So it's just a basic need of hairstyling. And this need, men can also need these needs, and women can also, you know, need this kind of need. So I think these tools can be used by both female and male people. So it's just like a myth. Like, I myself use hair tongs and hair straighteners and blow dryers. I always recommend all the men and women to use the same. I mean, there's no harm if you're using everything.
Sankey, can you just be a little closer to the device, or maybe, you know, I'm getting some of the comments which is just saying that you are not that audible. Yeah, I think, you know, okay. So Sankey, now, I mean, I think this is about the technical part, you know, where we are going to talk about a lot of things regarding styling tips and tricks. Now, you know, one of the questions which I keep thinking about you as a personality is that, you know, you got inspired from your mother, right? So she was already a beautician, and, you know, you kind of you were looking up to her, and then slowly and steadily you started developing your roots very strongly into the same thing. You know, how did that happen? You know, I mean, it's just amazing to hear that, you know, somebody picking something as a legacy and then doing such an exceptional work.
So I'll tell you what happened. So my mother was a beautician, and she would always, you know, blow dry her hair on her own. she would, you know, do her own makeup while going out. And since she would teach, you know, all the girls, and we had this home classes thing, so my all the girls would come home and, you know, learn from my mother. So for me, it was very intriguing to see my mother's work and to see how fascinating that particular thing is. So my mother never taught me, you know, you do this, you do that. I just used to sit beside my mother and see, watch how she is doing it and how, you know, she's teaching other people. And that's how I started trying on my mother itself. She's like, okay, fine, if you want to try, just try. And I tried it on my mother. So my mother made me do her facial. My mother made me cut her own hair. My mother asked me to color her own hair. So these are the things which literally kept me going. And I thought it is just an, you know, it is just a hobby that I would, you know, want to do it, which is why I was doing it. I never thought I would actually continue doing it until now. So yeah, this is something which is really, like, you know, fascinating for others to know how I became a hairstylist.
Absolutely, absolutely. I mean, this is super amazing, Sankey, without any saying. I mean, Sankey, let's just, you know, move back to the topic again. Yeah. And then, you know, there are people who have also started asking questions. So one of the questions which comes is that, you know, what does a cool shot do in hair dryer? What does a cool shot, you know, is actually being used in hair dryer?
What is it? Sorry, I can't hear you.
Sankey, cool shot in a hair dryer.
Cool shot in a hair. You mean the cool settings of the hair dryer you're talking about?
Okay. Yes.
So there are certain uses of blow dryer. Blow dryer can be used to blow dry completely your hair, and it sets your hair completely. Blow dryer can be also used as a blast dryer. Blast dryer means once you come out of the shower, you towel dry your hair, and then you randomly, you know, dry your hair. That is called a blast dry. Blow dry is something which you create sections and you blow dry section wise. So cool dry is something which is very important. Again, once you heat dry your hair, you have to cool dry it, because cool dry always helps you set that particular section and gives you the better results in terms of styling.
Absolutely. Yeah. And Sankey, I mean, people also want to check with you that, you know, does that hair dryer also result into damaging of your hair, or is it something, you know, which is just a myth?
Okay. Again, I would like to say, I mean, people use a lot of tools. People use curlers, people use blow dryers, and they also ask, what if this damage my hair? But I would like to say, at the end of the day, you have to take care of certain things. When I talk about using a blow dryer, you need to understand about a few things, like, you need to understand the heat settings, the amount of heat that you're using. You need to also keep one thing in mind: before using anything, you have to apply a product which is called as heat protection or thermal heat spray, which is very important. You need to layer that product into your hair, and then you need to blow dry your hair. That what that would do, that will prevent your hair from heat damage or any kind of damage to your hair. Which is why heat protection is one of the very important tools that I recommend everybody to use it, not just professionals, but also people who want to get themselves groomed on their own.
Yeah, thank you so much. Sankey, this allows me to now talk a little about, you know, various hairstyles. You know, there are certain trends which are being getting followed these days. Bollywood, definitely, you know, we know that is a trendsetter. And you being a traveler, you know, you also keep traveling here and there, and you love traveling. You know, you must be coming across certain unique styles. You know, one of them, for example, is beachy waves. I just read in one of the articles. So what all is trending these days? And, you know, what all styles you think that are important? And, you know, you would like to kind of explain to our audience today that, you know, this is what you should carry. Of course, monsoons are around and people are also worried about that. You know, how can they, in monsoons also, quickly carry a good hairstyle? So, I mean, to sum up, let's say, you know, two questions. One, what kind of styles? Second, in monsoons, which is the best suitable style for them?
Okay. So, when it comes to hairstyles, it depends on what you are wearing. That is secondary, to be honest. The first thing is, it depends on the shape of your face. You need to understand the structure of your face and then go for certain, you know, hairstyles. when I talk about hair coloring, you need to understand your skin, you need to understand your the tone of the skin and decide what color would literally go on your personality. Also, at the end of the day, you are going to carry that particular style. So you need to talk to yourself if, you know, I'm good to carry this particular style. If I'm good, I'm confident enough, then only I'll, you know, opt for this particular style. Otherwise, you know, I wouldn't do anything that I wouldn't be able to carry. That's first thing that I would like to say. So there are various styles of, you know, trendy styles that people are opting out these days, like sleek hair. You know, sleek hair doesn't go with everybody, you know. There are a lot of people who opt for it, but again, it also depends on the face, the structure of the face, and the personality. If you're going to carry it well, then go for it. If you're not, then there's no point doing and then being uncomfortable in that particular look. When it comes to monsoon, we have to be ready when it comes to monsoon. Being like, you know, being Mumbaikers, we know what monsoon does to us, right?
Yeah.
So monsoon is nothing. Blow dries are always important when it comes to monsoon because you get wet all the time. Hairstyles that I would like to suggest in monsoon is keep your hair straight. Don't go for any textures because, again, if you try and keep your hair, you know, styling, it might get ruined because of the monsoon, which is why, I mean, just keep it easy, breezy and very, like, effortless.
And Senge, I also read somewhere, you know, in one of the articles, you know, where you were interviewed, you mentioned about a style called the swirly and twirly hairstyle. What is that?
Swirly and twirly hairstyle. Are you talking about the pony? I mean,
I just read it. I mean, I was quite amazed to hear about that name, the swirly and twirly hairstyle.
Swirly and twirly is that the thing that I was talking about was textures. We always play with different textures. And yeah, I mean, hair tong, you know, plays a very important role when it comes to textures. You create different textures. When I talk about texture, there are like different textures. There are waves, there are tight curls, there are soft curls, there are like, you know, waves also has different types. Beach waves, you have glamorous waves, you have tussle hair. So these many textures which people don't know about, you know, a lot of people ask me questions, oh, what is this called? What is that called? You can call your hairstyle according to your, you know, according to you. I mean, whatever, however you are doing, you just can give a name to your hairstyle. So there's nothing called, you know, there's only one name which goes on that particular style. So twirly twirly is nothing, it's just my, you know, defined name to that particular hairstyle.
Absolutely. Great. Now, I mean, this brings me to another, you know, one of the questions, you know, which people are asking and because the comments are flowing in and people want to know that, you know, sometimes it happens, you know, that the hair start getting frizzy and, you know, by using certain tools like a hair straightener or something, especially people feel that, you know, the hair start getting frizzy. Why is that? And is there a trick which you can tell them that, you know, this is something the way they should do it and hence can avoid frizz in the hair?
Okay. So the frizziness of hair also depends on the water that you use for washing, because a lot of times, you know, water differs, right? Everywhere. So north side, the water differs. Mumbai has different water. South has different water. So that is very important for hair. The water that you use for washing is one thing that can literally, you know, create frizz in your hair. Secondly, the kind of shampoo you guys are using. I mean, you need to know what kind of shampoo literally suits you. A lot of people don't know what kind of shampoo literally suits them. So, I mean, still they keep complaining, oh, my frizz is not gone, I'm just using this shampoo. Also, you need to give time to that particular shampoo and conditioner to literally, you know, get used to your hair. Once your hair gets used to that shampoo and conditioner, then you see what the results are and then decide if you have frizz or not. Okay, now to prevent frizziness, you need to also do a little bit of treatments which are necessary, like deep conditioning treatment, which can literally help you remove the frizz. But one-time treatment won't help you. You have to keep on doing it at least for 6 months if you need your frizz to go away. There are some different techniques like use masks people don't know anything about masks. Now people think masks and conditioners are one and the same. No, mask is something which literally covers and layers your hair. It protects from UV rays and it protects from dust and other particles in the hair. So these are some important points that you need to remember when it comes to frizz. Frizz also, to prevent frizz, you need to use lotions, like smoothing lotions. Once you come out of the shower, just in your towel, right hair, use smoothing lotions. There are so many lotions which actually has UV protection in it. So you can use those lotions. You can keep trimming your hair time to time, because since people don't trim their hair time to time, I think frizz is something which stays and it bothers a lot of people because of that. So keep trimming hair, use high intensity shampoo, use high intensity shampoos, shampoos which literally can help you remove the frizz from your hair. But for that, again, I said you need to give time and see how it works. So these are a few things which you need to keep in mind when
absolutely thank you so much. Now I mean, again, let's little bit of I mean, let's shift a little bit towards you and, you know, talk about, you know, Sankey, one particular celebrity, you know, which you think you have not styled yet, and in future if you get a chance to style and you will go ahead and do it with, you know, just because out of the passion and the love that, you know, this is what I wanted to do and I have achieved that.
Oh, there are like a lot of people that I haven't worked with, to be honest. But yeah, I would love to work with Deepika, Sonam and all. Like, I haven't yet though, but I would love to work with and give some different style to them. And yeah, I mean, there are so many people, like, you know, there are not like there's not just one person. Okay, my dream was to work with Marilyn Monroe, which is one of my favorite stars. And she's no more, to be honest. But I always wished, if I was, you know, born in 1920s or 1910, I would have become like a hairstylist and would have styled for her. You know, she's like my inspiration, and my style is all about vintage styles. And I love, that's my forte. I love doing and creating things which are like old Hollywood glam and old Hollywood charm. So this is something that I wanted to do. But nevertheless, I will do this on someone.
Yes, of course. Yes, right. I mean, that remains Marilyn. I can tell you that, you know, is one of my favorites as well. You know, it is just because of the vintage hairstyle, you know, that she used to carry. That's why you think that, you know, she was one of the, you know, the favorites. That's why I feel
I
that.
Love,
you know, she was...
I love creating vintage styles.
Yes. You know, I mean, that's something which you always kind of, you know, relive that, you know, that was a time when people used to actually carry their hair in a very different style and a very unique style. And they were all natural, I would say, you know,
yeah.
The way it used to come.
Yeah.
Wonderful. I think, Sankey, I mean, we have talked a lot about female grooming. So now, of course, there are a lot of male audiences who are there on this. So, I mean, the first thing which audience wants to know is that, you know, these days people go to salon. I mean, people used to go to salon during before lockdown, but during lockdown, of course, it was difficult going to salon. But then, you know, they feel that until unless they get a proper beard done from salons, you know, it is not at all possible doing a beard cut at home, or now keeping the mind in lockdown. So it is even difficult to cut hair at home. There are various innovative products, you know, which have been launched by various brands. However, what is your take on this? What do you think that, you know, which kind of tools are possible for doing a DIY kind of a stuff at home?
Yeah. So first of all, trimming your own beard at home is not at all difficult, to be honest. I had a beard like, you know, a few years ago, and I used to trim my own beard. I never let anybody touch my beard because I had that fear, you know, what if somebody, you know, cuts me or cuts me there. So the fear of that actually made me do and made me trim my own beard. So for me, I only would like to recommend use easy trimmers, use easy clippers that can literally, help you trim your own beard, and don't shy away from trimming your own beard. I mean, a lot of people, a lot of men, a lot of friends of mine, they come to me and they're like, okay, I'm really scared of trimming my own beard. I mean, you're not. Until now, there were salons, there were hairstylists who were doing things for you, which is why you never got a chance to do it on your own. But now, because of lockdown, now there is nothing. You have to do it, right? I mean, there's no other option. So, yes. You know, easy trimmer, like I have used this Havells, this trimmer, which I really loved it. And this one, in fact, this trimmer. I actually cut my hair today on my own.
Oh, wow.
So I used this trimmer and I cut my own hair. And it was amazing. Like, I think I'm going to use this all the time. So beard trimming is not at all difficult. I have guided a lot of friends of mine virtually how to, you know, trim your beard. So just take help from your hairstylist, or there are a lot of, DIY videos on YouTube that you can see and do it. Just start using the clipper. It's not at all, hard work. And hair trimming also another thing which I would, it is a bit difficult, but nothing is, you know, impossible. You can still do it. So, just take a clipper and start doing it. Like, you have a lot of, like, you know, videos, and you can just see. Anyway, nobody's going anywhere in the lockdown. So even if you, you know, make a mistake, your hair will grow, and you know, you are gonna be back with your normal look.
Thank you so much, Sanky. I mean, this is really helpful. People would now understand that, you know, how styling tools can help them not only, you know, look good, but also, you know, there are certain tricks and which they can use, and you know, they can definitely do the beard styling at home. This is really helping us, you know, and it is really making now people ask many more questions. So I can see that, you know, there are a list of questions which have flowed in. So I have to pick again two of them. The first one comes from Mona Lisa, and she's asking one go-to styling tool to get any look. One go-to styling tool to get any look.
Okay. So, straightener, I would like to, you know, recommend straightener is a tool that you can, you know, create different textures by using a straightener. So, straightener can also straighten your hair. Straightener can also create waves in your hair, and straightener can also create curls in your hair. So straightener is one thing which you know completes half of your kit, to be honest. Rather carrying like three tongs, can use just one straightener and just create things out of it.
True. Thank you. Now I move on to the next question. So how do you stay updated regularly on the latest styling trends?
Okay.
How do you, I think this is for you also, Sanky, how do you stay updated on the latest styling trends?
Today we are in 2020s, and being in 2020s is internet is everywhere, you know, even like now kids have been using internet. So when you have internet, I keep on updating myself on international trends. In fact, I keep on creating my own new styles. I have a dummy. I keep practicing on it, and you know what is going around the world. Just go see what people are doing, you know, not just in, you know, the Asian continent, but you also go towards America, you go Australia, what people are doing it. Like, you know, now VMA awards also happened, and you know, celebrities were carrying different looks. So just go try, you know, see different things, and learn on your own. So keeping yourself updated is very important in this era. Like today, not just hairstylists, but also other people are aware of new trends and new fashion, whatever comes. So this is how I keep myself, updated through magazines, through websites, through all the shows and everything.
Yeah, right. Thank you so much. Hope, you know, the questions got answered now. You know, one of the clues which I pick up from your answer, Sanky, is that, you know, you are also a firm believer of trials and errors.
Yeah.
You know, and how does that, I mean, a person like you who is a hardworking guy, who is passionate about things, you know, who knows that how to style celebs, how can you think about trials and errors, and how can you suggest to others that, you know, you go and do a trial and then maybe, you know, you'll end up doing something crazy. So what is that all about?
Since I have learned from my own mistakes, for me, trials and errors are the most important part of my career, like in fact in any career, it's not just my career, but this is an important aspect that everybody needs to know. Until and unless you don't try, you don't make a mistake, you won't learn anything from it. So a lot of terms in the hairstyling, I would not know, like in the past, you know, like, oh, I did this, but this was already there. This was something which has come to me always whenever I, you know, worked with someone. And at the end of the day, when you make mistake, you learn from that mistake, you get to know, oh, this shouldn't have been like this, this should have been like that. So next time onwards, I'm not going to do this in this way, I'm going to do in some other way. And that's how it's going to look nice. So aesthetics, hairstyling aesthetics are something which are very important. You need to focus on aesthetics. You need to know what is correct aesthetically and what is not correct aesthetically. I mean, a lot of people, a lot of people go for sleek hair. But aesthetically, if that sleek look is suiting that particular personality, is it correct? Ask yourself, you know, you need to update yourself in terms of aesthetics. Ask yourself if it's looking good in, you know, genuinely you get an answer from inside, from your heart. If it's looking correct, your heart will say yes. If it's not, your heart will say no. So for me, I always work on my aesthetics. I still am working on my aesthetics, which also is connected to trials and errors at the end of the day. And that's how it works.
That's how it works. So, you know, this is something
good.
Yeah. And this is something, you know, which we kind of avoid, you know, when we are launching a product in the market. So this is something, you know, which we say that, you know, until unless we have tried it and we have tried it on ourselves and on our people. So we will never launch it into the market. So, I mean, that's where it kind of came at as an interesting question to me. And, you know, the answer which I get is absolutely correct. Until unless you try, until unless you experiment, you know, how would you get to know that, you know, what is the style which is going to suit on you, on your face? Because everybody is unique. Everybody has different type of, you know, face, and then probably the color, the skin color, which you mentioned earlier. So it I think makes a lot of difference. Thank you. So this makes me to move to another question, which now comes from one of the male. And then it is about, you know, any tip which you would give somebody that, you know, how to trim the hair at the back. You know, it is most difficult portion when you are doing a DIY haircut, probably. It is not easy to, because, you know, how would you do it at the back? And any clue which you would like to give, because you must have tried it on yourself.
Yeah, today I did, of course. So before answering this question, I have a tutorial which is there on my page. Just go on my page and see, you know, there is a tutorial where I've cut my own hair and I've recorded the entire thing. But yeah, I haven't done anything from behind. I haven't recorded that. So to cut your hair, which is at the back, you have to place one mirror, you know, at the back and one mirror at the front. So you can literally see your reflection, you know, falling on that mirror. And then accordingly, you know, create your section and then cut your hair. I mean, that's how I'm right now describing it. It seems very easy, but for other people, it won't be easy. So this is the time, if you really sit and practice and try to do that, it's not impossible. You can literally do it.
Yes. And you being in being in home and you're not going to office. So even if you once or twice you go wrong, that's where, you know, you will understand
just,
and learn.
Find your hair literally grows back and, you know, you don't need to worry about it.
Yes. So, Sanket, just tell me something, you know, this has been a question which is coming to my mind since morning, is that, you know, you made your Instagram handle name as Mad Hair Scientist.
Yeah.
You know, why do you call this as Mad Hair Scientist?
So, again, my best friend who pushed me for that shoot, her name is Nalakshi, and she's a plus-size blogger. And we had this very small blog. We were in the same college, and we had this small beauty blog. So, since she is, like, plump, and she's, like, a plus-size model, we had this one idea that let's create something for plus-size women, you know? A lot of, until now, we have seen all the looks on all the petite models, all the thin models, but nobody has shown anything on a plus size model, right? So she's like, with this plus size face, let's create something which can also make them look beautiful. and we tried doing that, and we literally, you know, it was a huge success for us because it was looking so nice. People had actually, people are still appreciating her for her looks and her, like, the way she carries herself. And, you know, we both can't thank each other enough for creating that blog and, you know, doing all of that thing. So since I created different looks, and she's like, let's create some name. And that's how she, you know, she's a very good writer also, and her English is better than mine. So she derived this name called the Mad Hair Scientist, since you do everything which is, you know, which is wacky and mad, and you can go to any level if it comes to hairstyling, that's how she derived this name, the Mad Hair Scientist. And scientist is someone who keeps on trying new looks and keeps on trying creating, you know, new things, which is why scientist was an appropriate name for me, and she thought she could give it.
Super amazing, super amazing. I think this is a story that people would really want to know about. So I think it's really interesting. So Sankey, another question which comes in from the audience now is that, you know, most demanded hairstyle by celebrities, both male and female.
Okay. Hairstyle, I work with a lot of celebrities, and I think 90% of celebrities love keeping their hair open. I mean, open hair is like beauty. And when we talk about Bollywood celebs, of course, like Bollywood with flowy hair and soft hair, you know, which is like flying in the camera, it looks super romantic and super nice and quite dreamy. So, you know, a blow-dried, you know, big volume and amazing tussled hair looks great, and it gives that drama in that camera which is needed in the movie. So this is something that a lot of celebrity, you know, ask for when I work with them.
Wonderful. So any distinction between male and female? I mean, you talked a lot about female, and I read a lot of female stylists, you know, which you have been really doing your stuff, I mean, in and around them. However, how about a male celebrity here? Any male celebrity you think that, you know, you kind of opt for and you feel that, you know, is the one guy who always carries himself in a way, and he's a trendsetter for the youth of the country?
See, there's only one celebrity that I think I really want to work with is Ranveer Singh, because actually, you know, doesn't have qualms about anything on trying. He literally goes to any level when it comes to, you know, wearing something or opting any hairstyle or makeup or anything. He loves trying new things, and I think I really would love to work with him and give something which he has never done before.
Great. I think I truly buy your point. Yes, right.
Yeah.
Sankey, I mean, why don't you just, you know, again, give a little bit more about you as a personality, that, you know, why don't you tell us that, you know, the journey for you has been all about hard work. I agree. And you told that.
Yeah.
But then, you know, you also got to a point where you started getting very good assignments. You know, you've been styling various Bollywood celebs. But then, you know, there must have been one moment where you felt that, you know, this is something was the biggest challenge I have faced in my life. And this is something, you know, which has made me learn so much. And, you know, this is what I would always talk about, and this I have created a memory for myself.
Yeah, I have something to say, to be honest, because when it comes to challenges, my entire career was like, you know, like a challenge. Because when you are on your own and people are there to guide you, but at the end of the day, you have to perform, because when you perform, people are going to judge your work. People are not going to judge other people who are guiding you, right? So I'll tell you from initial days of my career, when I was like a new hairstylist, I didn't even have like a proper kit. So I literally faced a lot of problems when I didn't have a proper kit. I just had, when I went for my first shoot, I had just like a dryer, a comb, and like a straightener and a brush. That's it. I didn't have other things. I only had these four things. And I still remember this photographer taunting me, saying, "Oh, you have a very big bag." And I was like, "Okay, what does that mean? I don't know. So it started from there. Then I, you know, slowly, gradually, I started collecting tools, products. I kept myself updated about all the products in the market, all the tools in the market. I bought those things. Then another thing, I didn't know how to do films. So film shoots are actually different than what we still shoot. And in 2018, Houseful 4 was my first movie, and I was styling Kriti Kharbanda, and I didn't
Oh.
know how to work in a film on a film set. To working on a film set is completely different. But Kriti actually now has become like a part of my life. She's my best friend, and she's taught me so many things. How to literally touch up in between the shots, how to see the monitor, how to see what is important, what is not important. For the wide shots, you don't need to see a lot. In the close-up shots, you literally have to see which side is the camera placed, and according to that, you need to create a hairstyle. So these are small challenges that I have, faced when I started shooting for the films. But today I can tell, because of her, I've learned so much. And
Yes.
now I did two movies with Sara. The second is still going on, and I think now I can literally Sara can literally rely on me when it comes to, monitor, because hair actually plays very important role when it comes to, filming and movies. Sometimes because
Yes.
of hair, your shot actually could go for a toss, and it can give a very bad result. So, these are some challenges that I faced, and I'm literally, thanking Kriti for teaching me so much about films and how to work on set and everything.
Right. Moving back to the topic, Saiki, so just tell me that, which are the tools, because it is today's topic is about, the myths on styling tools. So can you tell me, which are the styling tools one should carry always with them? And then, you can also talk about that these are the styling tools which will never ever damage your hair. Of course, you talked about, using those heat protective things, but then you must be sure that, these are certain tools which one should have, and these are the tools which will never damage the hair. And these are the tools, which can always give you those different unique styles which we talked about in the start of the session.
Yeah, so basic tools one needs to know, and basic kit that I always recommend a lot of people that you need to have in your hair kit is like a blow dryer. You need to have a straightener, a tail comb. That's it. I mean, and your heat protection, of course, that, and a hairspray if you feel like, and if you want, and if you don't want to use products, then you even can't, like, it's okay if you don't use it. But I think these five things you need to know. But at the end of the day, if I talk about damaging your own hair, you are whole and sole responsible for it. So why? Because the heat setting that you're gonna use, it depends on that. So how if a person it depends on the person how he or she is gonna use that tool. See, heat is involved in every tool. I'm not saying it's not. Heatless, and if you want to opt for heatless styling, then you have to give that entire time, and you have to make a lot of efforts to have that heatless styling. But nowadays people don't have time to go to opt for heatless styling, which is why they use blow dryers and straighteners and everything. So might as well you also use heat thermal spray and other tools to prevent hair from, very like heat damage. So blow dryer, straightener, and a tail comb, your thermal spray. And like maybe a brush if you really want to blow dry your hair like in detail. So these are the five, six things that you need to understand and keep in your hair kit.
Yes, right. Wonderful. That's what we kind of always recommend people to at least, have these basic tools in their kits. So, I
And
mean, wonderful.
blow dryer is, what is the basic use of blow dryer is drying your hair. You can't keep your hair wet. Keeping your hair wet can also damage your hair, which people don't know. I mean, a lot of people, I've seen a lot of female friends of mine, they wash their hair and then they go to the office directly like that. I mean, exposing your hair to the sun directly, not using any lotion, not using any heat protection. You have UV, you have heat protection or for your skin, right? You use it for your face. At the
Yes.
same time, you have to also use heat protection spray or lotion to your hair. It's not only tools. Heat which damages your hair, it's also your UV rays which comes out of the sun can damage your hair.
Wonderful. I think that's what people were looking for. Sanki, just I mean, another question which is coming from the audience side is that, you know, why do you think that, you know, a straightener is being not being today these days is not being used by male? I also learned that, you know, now these days I mean, guys have started using, of course, dryers is something which was very popular earlier. Slowly and steadily, guys learned that, you know, dryer is something which we can definitely use every now and then. But then, is straighteners also something, you know, which guys can use, depending upon the hair length, of course?
Yeah. Straightener is also very important for men, which I think they are not aware of. But straightener, we get different sizes in straighteners. So we have like smaller straightener to the big straightener. So the smaller straighteners that are available in the market are used by men. There are some small sections of the hair which big straightener can't straighten, but there are some you know, sections which can be straightened by very small straightener, and that's how, you know, men can also use straighteners. Men hair have like less length, like very short length, so that small straightener can also reach every part of your hair, and you can straighten those frizzy hair, or some part of the hair has frizz, some part doesn't have the frizz. So these small straighteners are like well being used by men.
Yeah.
I have used like for myself. Like I have a small straightener which I always use it.
Right. And I think after launching a men's hair dryer, Havells also learned this fact that, you know, now, I mean, there's a need definitely to launch a straightener also. So for male, we do have a hair dryer, but now I think with this statement from you coming in, we are doubly sure that, you know, we sometime need to launch a hair straightener for men also, which is definitely going to be smaller and sleeker one.
Yeah.
Thank you. I think, Sankey, I mean, really a great session, a wonderful wonderful interaction with you. A lot to learn in this episode of Havells School of Grooming. I mean, before we kind of, you know, close this session for today's evening, it'll be great if you can just give one last trick of the session, you know, which makes a lot of sense for all the people who are watching this show.
In terms of like what, Mike? Like in terms of career, or like in terms of grooming, or like how?
I think in terms of grooming,
I will address both the things, to be honest. To all the aspiring hairstylists, I have one thing to say: just, you know, keep doing your hard work, keep updating yourself, keep trying things if you are learning on your own right now, because none of the academies or training things are open right now. So don't shy away from hard work. Just keep going on. Focus on your work, what you have to do. If you're aspiring, good. All I need to say, just keep doing the hard work. And when it comes to grooming, don't have the fear that you won't be able to do it. It won't look nice. If you think it will look nice, just go for it. Try things in the house, because right now you can't go anywhere. And since you have all the time in the world, just even if you make mistakes, you are going to learn from it, and yeah, just go for it.
Wow. I mean, that's what we were looking for, Sankey. I mean, it's a great word to just kind of sum up this session. And, you know, I thank you, first of all, for being part of Havells School of Grooming. And, you know, it has been always great to have people like you, because, you know, this is where this platform has been created. People want to learn here. They want to understand, you know, what are the tips and tricks of grooming. And, you know, that's what is, you know, hearing from, I mean, the mouth of, you know, the hairstylist like you, who are especially self-taught. It is amazing. You know, the energy was flowing throughout the session. It was great to have you. I mean, have a great day and a great time ahead. All the best.
Thank you so much for making me a part of this entire, you know, live session. I, you know, people ask me about my career, but I think I'm not bragging about myself, but I think people also learn a lot from it, and they can relate to me. If they are, if a lot of people don't have money to, you know, spend in these academies where they can go spend and learn on their own. But yeah, I mean, I would like to say you can learn on your own if you have that genuine determination in you. And yeah, I mean, that's how it is. Like, I keep motivating people, and people need that these days. A push can literally push people to another level.
Absolutely. Great, thank you. I mean, thank you so much, for this great, session, first of all. And then, I thank audience as well for being a part of this session.
Yeah,
Keep
I'm so
looking for more
glad that
action.
2,000 people online and watching, and I've never
Yes.
had such audience, to be honest. Thanks to Havells India, thanks to you.
Thanks to you. Of course, that's the power of brand Havells. That's what we kind of ensure that people keep coming to us, keep learning from us. We believe in education. That's where we have created this property. Once again, thank you, audience, for coming in. Take care. Take care of your hair as well. That's the most important thing.
Yeah, that's the most
Love you,
important
and
thing.
had a great session.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.